Hello Android developers, my name is Mohsen and in this video I want to talk about Kotlin language scope functions and how to decide which one is the best for which use case. Before I start, I have to mention I am speechless with all the positive feedback I am receiving from you, and thank you so much for all your support and following this channel and liking and sharing the videos. Kotlin is a modern language that brought many features to the table, and one of them is scope functions. Based on Kotlin documentation, the Kotlin standard library contains several functions whose sole purpose is to execute a block of code within the context of an object. They are being called scope functions because they form a temporary scope, and all variables introduced inside that block will be removed after the execution. Because the scope functions are all quite similar in nature, it's important to understand the differences between them. There are two main differences between each scope function. One, the way it refers to the context object, and two, what value it returns. Some of you may have already seen this flowchart of picking the best scope function. I will leave the article link on the video description and let you read it more later. But now I will briefly explain each one of the functions and possible use cases in an Android app as an example. Let's start with apply. Apply exposes the original object as this in the scope block and returns the original object itself in the end. It means you can apply any changes you need to the receiver object and in the end get that object back as result. It is useful for configuring an object before assignment. In the first simple example, we are applying a field value to a newly created foo object and then assigning it to the foo variable. In the second Android example, you can see how nice and easy it is to create an intent and put all the extras and action into it before assigning it to the variable. Also in the third Android example, we apply a field style to a newly created paint object before assigning it to the paint variable. Let's continue with run. Run exposes the original object as this in the scope block and returns the result of the block execution. It means you can use the object to run some codes and return the calculation result. It is useful for configuring an object and computing the result. As you can see in the first example, we created a foo object and then by assigning a value to the field one, we execute the method of toBar and just return the value of that. Run can also be used as a standalone function to run a block of code. The use case of this form factor is that it can group several statements into an expression, and all the variables introduced in that block will be killed after the execution. In the second example, you can see that we have a run block, and inside that block, we create a foo object, define a field, and then execute toBar, and the result of this method execution will be returned, and the foo object will be deleted after all. The next one is also. Also exposes the original object as it in the scope block and returns the original object itself. It is useful for doing additional effects involving the object. For example, here we have a new foo object, and using the also block, we do execute something using that foo object. In the second Android example, you can see we have a make directory method which receives a path, and using that path, create a file object and then make a directory out of it. Now that we know the usage of also, we can continue with let. Let exposes the original object as it in the scope block and returns the result of the block execution. Let is useful for executing a lambda on a non-null object. In the first example, we get a foo object, which is nullable, and then only run the let block if it's not null. And if it's null, we just return null value. As you can see in the second Android example, we are defining a type converter for a list of int, and let allows us to run the block only if list is not null. And if it's null, we just return the null value. Just make sure you won't fall into indentation hell. Sometimes an if is null then return makes the code much simpler and indentation free. As you can see in the third example, it's way cleaner to return if the value is null instead of trying to use the let. Let can also be used to introducing an expression as a variable in a local scope. For example, you can see in the parentheses we have an expression, and using that let, we get the expression result and do something with it. For both also and let use cases, I suggest for a better code readability, if the block is more than one line, you give a proper variable name instead of it and use it in the block. Last but not least, we've got with. With get an object and return the block result. One could argue that this is the same as run, but the answer is that the with is not an extension function. It's useful for grouping function calls on an object. For example, here we create the foo object and pass it to with, and in the block we assign a field and execute toBar method and return the result. In the second Android example, you can see how we remove the binding from the beginning of all lines inside the block just by using with. By having all this knowledge, I believe it's now easier to pick a scope function for each use case. Plus, do not forget that practice makes perfect, and you will get the mindset after using them more and more inside your code and get the benefit from them. One more trick is to read that line of code as an English sentence and try to fit one of the scope functions based on that. Let's keep in mind that this trick sometimes doesn't work as you expect. Hopefully this review helps you to pick them more wisely and avoid misusing or overusing them. That's it. Thanks for watching the video, and do not forget to like, share and subscribe to channel for more support. See you in another Android Development Lightning Tips and Tricks video. Bye.